I guess he has like trust issues with women or whatnot. So I'm like sharing my location with him just to make him feel comfortable. Is that
Have you had any therapy?
Yes, I have in the past.
You need to go back.
Oh my gosh, really?
You're already trying to make him feel comfortable 2 weeks into it.
Right.
That's too much proving to do. You're not his wife.
I'm just being nice and being like,
that's
hey,
not being,
like,
no, it's not, no, no, it's not being nice. It's being a people pleaser. That's not normal. That's not normal. You want to be nice? All right, let's go out a couple of times. I need you to give me $10,000. Be nice. Oh, be nice. No. I mean, come on, be nice. I mean, come on, be nice. I need $10,000 and we need to go ahead and run the soul train on you. Be nice.
No. That's...
Of course. So there are things that sound crazy to you.
Yes. Yes.
Sharing your location with somebody you've gone out with twice is crazy.
Okay.
I give myself a solid 9.8.
Being pretty is not enough for a lot of men because I'm pretty and I'm still single, so.
What do you want?
I don't know. I really don't know what I want because these men, they don't know what they want. A lot of men don't know what they want in women.
Mm. And you said you're how old again?
33.
So regardless as to what men want, you don't know what you want?
I mean, I know what I want, but...
Well, what is that? Guys, remember the first thing I said about ego? They're not willing to be honest.
Be honest with you, I ain't gonna lie. I don't know what I want in a man. Like, I've been screwed and fucked for so long, I don't know what I want in a man.
Just in this little bit of time of talking to you, it's been chaotic. I'm just asking you just the basic stuff about your who you are and what you want. And the way you've told the story is, yeah, you can't make this shit up, people.
To let you know, I have completely changed my life and made it 360.
The 360 puts you right back where you were, but I understand what you're saying.
I made a 180. I found Lord, and I got a man that's got money now.
I don't believe.
You found the Lord?
Yeah.
Where'd you find him at? I didn't know he was lost.
I didn't know where the Lord was.
Hmm. Okay. This is all inside of last 4 months, right?
3 months, 4 months. Yeah.
It's a lot of changing in 3 or 4 months. You said you got a man that has money now.
Yeah. I do. I just wanted to let you know also, I wear my bonnet in public. I saw what you had to say about that. You know, I get where you're coming from, but at the same time,
you can't
like,
make this shit up.
Hmm?
At the same time, you what?
Did you tell me shut up?
No. I said, go ahead. You said at the same time.
At the same time, I just don't see what the issue of wearing a bonnet in public is. I got married, but I don't want to be with
you. Got married?
Yeah.
You currently married?
Yes.
No. Mm-mm. Oh, you got to be kidding me. Ma'am, are you trolling me?
No, I'm not.
A platform with 1 million folks actively talking about leaving your husband to get back with your ex.
Because he's high value, and I felt like...
And the reason you want to break your covenant with God and wreck your home of the pipe fitter guy is because the previous guy was higher value, meaning he earns more money?
Yeah, and his social status, how he looks.
What would the world say about that man?
It would say that this woman he got back with is the one he always wanted.
She belongs to the streets. Like,
excuse my French, niggas alone, they always want to take me to court. Yeah.
What does that mean?
It means that it's like when I break up from with a guy, I go through divorces because they can't take me leaving them in the dust, in the dirt, where I left them at. Because they don't act right. So I have to move on. Is that right? Do you think that that's right of them?
Why are you such a poor judge of character to pick me and you gotta leave?
run that back, I couldn't believe it.
Oh, damn.
No,
oh, damn. Why are you such a poor judge? No, ma'am. I listened to what you said. You came in talking about how you feel like you're in divorce court because you got to leave these men in the dirt. And all I hear is you're a shit judge of character picking men because you don't leave quality men.
You absolutely right. So, God, please stop sending me.
That's No, God ain't got nothing to do with it. Please don't bring my God into this.
He couldn't have children anymore. And mm-hmm. he was unaware of that. So I like immediately divorced him because children was the outcome that I wanted to have. Ooh. It is what it is. It was terrible. But like I told him from the beginning, like I got married so we could have children. And then he found out he couldn't have children after we got married. So now I am actively looking.
Karma's a bitch. How do you know you're going to be able to carry your children to term?
Exactly. I know. That's what I do know that.
I'm asking seriously, ma'am, it's not really a value judgment as much as I'm just trying to hold a mirror up to you because you say the shit you say to people around you and they let you believe this stuff. I'm telling you, there's somebody who got no dog in the fight. How old are you?
35. Play in all types of arenas. I work in those arenas. I work in all of those.
Okay, how about this? Do me a favor.
Okay.
Talk to me like I'm four or a cocker spaniel, because you're not really saying anything. And you said you're how old again?
I will let you guess.
I don't play these games. You either answer my questions or I'll bid you a good night.
43.
Okay. One thing I don't do is I don't do these things. No, I don't know you, so you've been married.
We all know this. Keep going.
Well, I will say this though: you've gone from 35 to 43, just like that. That's amazing.
I did, didn't I?
Yeah. This is crazy. I don't like liars.
To date, not just to have a relationship. You don't have to put a title on everything, Kevin. That's what you need to start telling these people. A title, you don't.
No,
have
I need. To I need to. What I need to do is I need to direct people to this video and show you what's wrong. You don't need to put a title on nothing. It needs to just be free flowing. Yeah. Yep. And over here, stuff works. Where you at? It don't. You don't need to put a title on everything. You can have babies out of wedlock. You don't need to be married. You can do what you want to. Mm-hmm. We're the only community that operates like that. That's why we got to take power back from these mindsets. Have you ever opened up something at the building and it came with instructions?
Of course.
And it came with parts?
Of course.
The way you're talking is you just start doing shit. You don't need the instructions. You don't need that. Just start putting shit together. Uh-huh. You want to live on the fifth floor of a building like that?
You got me sweating, Kevin. I'm going to leave.
Mm-hmm.
I got to go.
So when's the last time you held a job?
Like a year ago. I was cashier.
Okay. And is that an injury or something?
No. I was fired for being late.
So you just lazy?
No. It was.
So you just tried
to? I was late.
Nice fingernails.
Thank you.
You do those yourself?
No.
You wouldn't got them done?
Mm-hmm.
Who paid for that?
I paid for them.
With what?
With the unemployment money.
Are you trolling me?
No, but Kevin, don't you think I have to look like something?
I think you need to grow up.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. If you were a man, they would call you a deadbeat. But the only reason you get away with this is because you got two kids and you get unemployment, so you're juking the state. Mm-hmm. And you got the nerve to have these fingernails up like you got money to pay for them. There's a football player, Brian Banks. He spent 5 years in jail. The woman who accused him of lied about it. She got $2 million in some sort of settlement or something, lot or whatever. Then she was found out to be lying. video evidence proof, her confessing that she made the entire thing up. Has she served one day in jail? Nope. So when they lock your son up, take his rights, ruin his life, not his, because once that's out there, it's there forever. It never goes away. No.
And then I raised my son right. I don't think my son would ever be in that situation. I'm just saying.
I want you guys to understand what she just said. I raised my son right. I don't think he'd ever be involved in that situation. You mean involved with a vindictive, lying woman?
Yeah.
Do you live in the United States of America?
Yes, I do.
Holy shit, that sounds bad.
You're making it sound bad. Yeah.
It's the truth. You have a 3-year-old who's a cancer survivor, and you're about to go out and put her off on a, not your mother, but your mother's mother.
Oh, she's in her, like, 80s right now. I mean, I'm happy, like, you're actually talking to me about this, because I would never know, like, if this is not okay or not.
What is so goddamn important that you got to get out to drop a 3-year-old with an 80-year-old?
Honestly, nothing. Like, I was honestly just trying to go out and, like, you know, I haven't been...
Blow off steam.
Yeah, I mean...
treating you the way that you feel like you should be treated or how you deserve to be treated. So it's always good to have a backup plan. But I'm not saying have a backup plan, because you should be faithful to your man always, no matter what.
Well, okay. Have you been drinking?
Have you been drinking?
No, we don't play that shit. You know how that goes.
Oh, okay. Yeah, I have.
Yeah, we don't do that shit. I don't play
no,
that snarky ass comment.
Last time.
No, I don't play that snarky comment.
No, but no.
Okay. So here's the thing. Okay, you.
Same thing as last time I went live with you. I was drinking.
Yeah. Last notice. I'm going to answer your question. I'm going to respond to your statement.
All right, go ahead.
If you're saying a man is not treating you right, get another man.
But the thing is.
No. Because if I flipped it up and saying if your woman ain't doing what you want to, and I told a man to go out and get some more ass, you wouldn't like it. You don't worry about, you don't have to ask the guy the kind of money he has, because the men you typically date are older and have money.
Yeah. But I think, I mean, in general,
But my point is, men your age wouldn't have stand a chance with you, because they most don't have money. Thank you.
Right. But I mean, to each their own, everyone is different. I think
everybody's different. We're more alike than anything else. And the bottom line is this. Would you like to be married one day?
Yes.
Okay. Are you going to be submissive and obedient to your husband? There she goes. You can't make this shit up, people. You can't make it up. Why didn't you marry the man you chose to have a child with?
He wasn't good enough for me.
Well, then that's your... Okay, so what I need you to understand... On the open dating market, you come into the open dating market with a baby from a man you say wasn't good enough for you. To us, to men like myself, to men with good sense, that would say she is a poor judge of character, because she gave a man the highest honor a woman can give any man on the planet, a child. And then she gave a man who wasn't good enough for her a baby. Sorry, ma'am. Don't get upset, because
I agree with that.
But if you agree with it, then understand.
I agree there's with that a reason. Part, but I also want to say that I'm allowed to make poor judgments in
yes,
my
but,
life because.
But oh, yeah,
I'm
you, oh, yeah, you are. But you are. Stop. No, yeah, you are. But we don't have. But understand some. Listen. You are. But the world does not owe you understanding.
So I cheated a lot in the beginning.
Okay.
Then I ended up leaving him. He cheated once, and I couldn't. Get over it. And okay. I haven't been able to get a solid relationship since then.
Child with him and then a child after him.
The child after him was like a revenge thing. I was upset. Yeah. Okay, right. And I had a child by his cousin.
Oh, Jesus.
My question is, I'm trying not to be salty towards like all men. And I'm trying
Why should you be salty? I mean, ma'am, no disrespect, but What you just said is you told a story where you were a young woman dealing with a man, and for 10 years, you were fucking around. He cheats one time.
No,
and you
no,
bounce.
Not the whole 10 years. Not the
doesn't
whole
matter. 10. It doesn't matter. 10 years, 3 years, 5 years, you were cheating a lot.
Yeah.
He cheats one time, then you decide to get salty and leave. And then on the way out, you screw his cousin and have a baby with him.
Well, it's not
and,
like his blood.
And I'm just getting the story right, ma'am.